I got some sad news for you guys in America, whether you like it or not. America has become very godless, anti-Christian, anti-Christ. Sorry to say that, but it's a fact. The America of today is not the America of the 70s and 80s and 90s that I remembered, nor is it the America of 100 years ago. And so it seems like, I don't know, I'm not a prophet, the next president will be Kamala Harris and her vice president, who's the governor of Minnesota. They're ultra extreme liberals, fascists, socialists, who are anti-God, anti-Christ, pro-murder, abortion, pro-LGBTQ, transgenderism. And it seems like they're going to win because they're showing at recent polls, Trump is trailing behind because of Kamala and her vice president. So this is what happens when you put your hope in a man and not in Christ. If you think Trump is your savior, the Lord's going to teach you a lesson. May we not look to a man and idolize him. So even if Trump is in power, it's inevitable. He's not going to last forever. And even though, in my estimation, Trump is much better than Biden, much better than Kamala, much better, he's still a narcissist, a womanizer, narcissist, egomaniac. So though Trump is way better, that tells you how fallen American is, that our best option is a narcissist. Guys, be realistic. Don't idolize Trump. So now, if that's your option, a narcissist, and you're looking him to save you, you see why we're in trouble, right? So I hope Trump repents, but if that's your best option, you are in sad shape. And we don't need Trump. We need Jesus to intervene, because when Jesus is pleased with a nation, he will then arise to defend the nation and give them leaders after their heart. So with that said, now that I've gotten you miserable and fearful, since some of you are panicking about what's going on, let me give you a word of exhortation, shall we? So here is how you should be in times of trials. Matthew 14, 22 to 33. Ready? Then he made the disciples get into the boat and go before him to the other side while he dismissed the crowds. And after he had dismissed the crowds, he went up into the hills by himself to pray. Notice our Lord made time to be alone with the Father. Lord in the flesh, Son of God, made time to be alone with the Father. Did you catch it? Learn from scriptures, learn from Christ, learn from the prophets and the apostles, learn from the prophets and apostles, things to do and the things not to do, and learn from the Lord. Right? Because he came to set forth an example. We need to take time away from spouses, children, friends, activities, and spend time alone with the Lord in meditative prayer. You do it as a family. The family that prays together stays together. You and your wife, children, make time to study scripture and pray together. We need to do this. Everyone see that before I move on? Okay, that's one. When evening came, he was there alone. Did you catch it? By himself. But the boat by this time was many furlongs distant from the land. What's furlongs? Other ancient authorities read was out on the sea. Okay, furlongs. That's Revised Standard Version for you. So they already went. They got on the boat. Now remember, these are experienced fishermen. They know the sea, the lake, the weather condition better than most. They're fishermen. But now watch. They're going to panic because they know we're in trouble. Beaten by the waves, for the wind was against them. And in the fourth watch of the night, he came to them walking on the sea. Now, I'm going to show you why the Lord is doing this. He's not showing up. We're going to see what he's doing. But when the disciples saw him walking on the sea, they were terrified, saying, "It is a ghost." And they cried out for fear. But immediately he spoke to them, saying, "Take heart, it is I, have no fear." Now, you know what the little Greek is here, right here? Take heart, ego me, right? I am, have no fear. So notice the first thing he says, "Do not be afraid. I am." Now, why I am, ego me? Because the words I am, ego me, and Greek and Hebrew, anihu or anokihu, are used by God, Yahweh, Yahuwah, in Isaiah and Deuteronomy as one of his self-designations, as a divine title to describe himself, especially in relation to his work of saving, preserving, and sustaining his people. Because he's now unveiling himself to the disciples, doing what the Old Testament says Yahweh does, in order to show them, I am Yahweh, the Son, who became flesh, and I am the Lord, who is sovereign over the elements. I am the Lord of heaven and earth. I am the Lord of the seas, the winds, and the wave, and I am the Lord over your circumstances. Don't let your circumstances drown you in fear. Focus on me. That's the message. But all right, now watch the point. And Peter answered him, Lord, if it is you, bid me to come to you on the water. He said, come. So Peter got out of the boat and walked on the water and came to Jesus. Now watch. As he focused on Jesus, he was walking on the water. Who enabled him? Jesus. The message is, if you trust in Christ, focus on Christ, he will empower you to trample under your feet the waves, the storms of your life. That's the message. This is a physical act pointing to a spiritual truth. But if you take your eyes off of the Lord, then the winds and the storms of your life will drown you and flood you. Because this is what happens. Learn. So Peter got out of the boat, walked on the water, and came to Jesus. But when he saw the wind, see, now he took his eyes off of Jesus, you see? That's what happened to you just a few minutes ago. All right? Saw the wind. When I told you about Kamala, and I told you about Tampon Tim, panic. Oh, here, my goodness. You see how fickle we are? May God have mercy on us. We're pathetic. I'm pathetic. So look, when he saw the wind, now he started focusing on the storms of life. He was afraid, beginning to sink, because he started doubting. He cried out, Lord, save me. Now, this physical miracle is pointing to a spiritual truth. Jesus immediately reached out his hand and caught him, saying to him, oh, man of little faith, why did you doubt? That's what he's saying. Why are you afraid? Have you forgotten who I am? I am the I am, the Lord Yahweh Almighty. I am sovereign. I have authority over the winds, the waves, the storms of your life. I'm in control. I will trample down the storms of your life if you trust me. You see the message? And when they got into the boat, the wind ceased. You see? Then the winds and the storms messing up your life went completely silent. Do you see the message? See the message? And those in the boat worshiped him, saying, truly you are the Son of God. Do you see the message now?